Shower thoughts. We've all been there before. Whether it's an early morning or late evening after a long day, you turn the shower on and wait for the water to heat up and hop in. Then all of a sudden, without realizing it, your brain starts to slowly drift into a new state of conscious creativity. It seems like some of our best ideas come to us while we're simply standing in the shower. But have you ever thought to ask yourself why? You might think it's simply because you're able to relax a little bit, so your brain has a chance to really concentrate. But it turns out it's more complicated than that, and the answer to why your best ideas come to you in this state isn't because part of your brain is being switched on, but because a very important part of your brain is switched off. Let's take a quick step back, because once you take some time to think about it, you may realize that this state of conscious creativity doesn't just occur while you're taking your daily shower. You might have also noticed it sneak up on you at other times, like while you're on a long drive, doing moderate physical activity like jogging, biking, or walking, even while you're engaged in learning something new, or doing a more challenging task that you're really good at. In psychology, these states of mind have been coined flow states, and their research has been spearheaded by Hungarian-American psychologist Dr. Mihai Csikszentmihalyi, who's one of the leading researchers in modern positive psychology. Csikszentmihalyi determined 9 characteristics for experiencing flow states. Most notably, during a state of flow, you experienced increased concentration, complete absorption with the activity at hand, modulation of how you experience time, and loss of self-consciousness. If you look at the times that you experienced any of these states, including your shower thoughts, you know that it's an incredibly positive experience. But what's actually happening to your brain during a flow state? Remember when I mentioned that part of your brain gets switched off? That part of your brain is called the prefrontal cortex, which is the executive function portion of your brain that's responsible for orderly sequential thinking, like outcome prediction and decision making. When this section of the brain is turned off or downregulated, it's through a process called transient hypofrontality. The word's less complicated once you break it down. Transient meaning temporary, hypo meaning under or lowered, and frontality meaning the frontal region of the brain. When your brain downregulates the prefrontal cortex, it frees up resources to be able to be redistributed to other parts of the brain. When this occurs, the brain enters into an altered state of creativity. So when you think of something simple like taking a shower, taking a drive, or going for a walk, since it's a task that you've done thousands of times before in your life, but still a task that involves your attention, the prefrontal cortex of the brain gets a little bit of a break. And since it's responsible for sequential thinking, which is why time distortion is a common experience in flow states, your ability to think laterally is greatly improved. This is where the creative ideation stems from. Flow states have a spectrum. Csikszentmihalyi modeled mental states based off of the balance of your skill level to the difficulty of the task at hand. Your shower thoughts would be considered what's called a low-grade flow state. And when you move up the scale of challenge level for the task at hand, the flow state that you entered into actually begins to consistently produce the same cocktail of neurochemicals that make you feel, well, they're the thing that keep you coming back to the things that you're good at. So they make you feel pretty great. They're the times in your life where you feel naturally energized, passionate, and engaged in what you're doing. So when it comes to having great ideas and creativity, remember the spectrum of flow states. Coming up with a new idea may be as simple as the low-grade flow state produced from your daily shower or your drive home, or you can increase the potency of the activity with a greater challenge. If you're looking for more information about flow state research, check out Csikszentmihalyi's book, Flow, The Psychology of Optimal Experience. And if you're looking for more information on how flow states impact high performance, and just an overall fantastic read, check out Stephen Kotler's book, The Rise of Superman, Decoding the Science of Ultimate Human Performance. Thanks for stopping by and learning something new. If you enjoyed this video, you can help our channel grow. Since YouTube recommends the content you engage with to more people, don't forget to drop down and destroy the like button for the YouTube algorithm.